Okay, hello, welcome to the Friday weekly update. So I'm going to be on a few different steps of a journey on this blog. The first thing is to say to you that this part of the school site will be closed in the morning and at the end of the school day as of Monday. So no access to cars for drop-offs, please, for the security and safety of all of our pupils. We have got the additional issue of the sports centre development going on, and the contractors have agreed that they will not bring their vehicles onto the school site during opening time in the morning and the close of school at the end of the day. So if parents can respect that, please, that would be really helpful. The other issue, of course, is because of the 3G sports pitch being developed, the access from Fifth Avenue to the car park down there is going to be restricted. So just be aware of that if you are dropping your child off from Monday onwards. Okay, so I'm going to take you over to the testing centre that we're going to have for the students from Monday. While I'm just taking that walk over there, I'll just hand you over to Miss Warner, who's going to talk about some of the contributions to World Book Day.
Start today by saying well done to everybody who has been reading at home over lockdown. Our engagement on Sora has been absolutely fantastic, and also chapter leaders have been feeding back to me about the physical books you've been reading as well. Well done, and I really hope that continues when we return to school as well. However, the main focus of today is for me to feed back about the World Book Day challenges that have been taking place over the last week in the school. So, firstly, we had book-inspired cakes. I loved this, loved seeing all the baking creations you've made. It was a really tough choice to decide the winner for this one. We did choose Olivia Hume in year eight, so she will be awarded a £10 book token. Well done, Olivia. She has made a Quidditch match-inspired cake, which you can see on the end there. She's got some of House Towers, and she's also got all the Harry Potter characters as well. It must be mentioned as well, I think Emma in year seven made some sorting cakes as well for inspired by Harry Potter, where instead of having the sorting hat, you would bite into a cake and it would tell you the colour of your house. And as well, Jake Fry in year seven made that amazing Hunger Games inspired cake and scenery as well. Well done to everybody who entered. Everyone who enters has got 50 tracking points, and then a special well done to Olivia. We then moved on to the Guess the Shelfie competition, and this is where members of staff shared examples from their bookshelf. And well done to Tom Robinson in year nine, who has also got a £10 book voucher, because he was the winner of that competition with 100%. Well done, Tom. We then move on to book-inspired art, and again, I'm always amazed with the talent that we have at the King's with regards to art. I also really loved that in this challenge we had entrants from year seven all the way up to sixth form. We had fiction entries and also a non-fiction one as well, which I was, thought was really good. And well done to Emma Pullinger in year seven. She has made, again, very Harry Potter heavy today. She did the Harry Potter inspired anime on the end. I just think it's absolutely outstanding. I really, really like all of the lines, all of the colour. I think the style's just brilliant, really original. So well done, Emma. We then have the Guess the Character and Book Title. This was another competition where students had to guess the character, which was dressed up by a member of staff or a member of their family or their pets. Well done to Liam. You also will get a £10 book voucher. For the Reading Buddy Challenge, it was great to have so many photos sent in of our students reading with other members of their family or their bubble. It was particularly nice to see so many of you reading with younger siblings, showing what good role models you all are. Everyone who took part has been awarded tracking points, and then the winner of the draw was Rihanna Jones, which I was really happy with because she sent in such a brilliant photo of her reading on her horse. Last but not least, our final World Book Day challenge was a book wave, and many of our chapters had a book wave this morning, which is where on Teams they waved to each other using either a book that they've enjoyed or that they're currently reading. It was great to have an insight into some of the books that you are choosing to read for pleasure at home. Well done to Matthew 7A, who were the winners of this challenge because they had the most participants waving their books on the call. So well done to Mr. Hinchcliffe's chapter. All of you can have 50 tracking points. So just to sum up, well done and thank you to everybody who has participated in any of the World Book Day challenges this week. It's been brilliant to receive them all in, and I can't wait to see you all next week.
Okay, so well done to all those who contributed to the World Book Day event. So in terms of the testing that's taking place next week, you will come onto site through this gate and you will take yourself around the back of the Sports Centre. So if you follow me around to the back, and I'll just give you a quick insight as to how the setup looks. Okay, so if you're coming in for a testing, you come through the sports door here and you will register at this desk here. Don't forget to come at your relative appointment time. Once you've been registered, you will be allocated one of three booths. And if you just look down the hall there, we've got booths 1, 2, and 3. Let's imagine for a second I've been given booth 3. So booth 3 is this line here. And there are 2 meter socially distanced markers. So if there are several people in the queue, you just keep moving forwards on the yellow markers on the floor. And eventually, you get up to the exciting point of being tested. So this is the last point. The weigh-in for each of the booths is on the right-hand side. And so I'll make my way around here. Into booth 3, and there'll be a person on that side of the screen who will take you through the testing process. And if Mr. Worthing just comes a little bit further around here, for a bit of discreetness and privacy, you can do the testing in this space here. So you can have it privately done back to the person who's testing you to do what you need to do. Once you've been tested, then the little arrow on the floor here shows you the way out. So I'm going to come out this way, and then I'm going to leave through these doors over here, and off I go home and ready for the next step. So watch the desk. That's the process that you go through. It's dead simple, dead straightforward. Nothing to worry about, and we will make sure that over the course of the 3 tests that you understand how to do the testing process, so if you opt to do them at home as well, you know exactly what you need to do. Okay, so I've now got a couple of shout outs. There are 2. One is to a young man called Jake Fry. Now Jake Fry had entered the Modern Foreign Languages poetry recital, and he has produced an absolutely superb video, all dressed up in French, speaking French poetry. Jake, I watched the video, it was fabulous. And I know that's gone forward to the competition. So good luck with that one, and well done, it was very impressive. The second shout out goes to a winner of Pride of the Kings. And this one is going to a young man in year 11, Cameron Sherman. And Cameron, for me, has been nominated by his chapter leader. And I think this one here about going out of his way to make someone's life more enjoyable. The narrative for this one is around inviting somebody in to participate who felt a little bit excluded or not involved in an activity. And something that's been repeated time and time and time again. So for that reason, I think it's a fabulous nomination. So Cameron, you get your certificate. So when you're in on Monday, you can pick that up. And of course, if you come around this way, because you are now Pride of the Kings, you, young man, I'll leave the keys there, get to go on the exclusive Pride of the Kings wall. So well done, Cameron, brilliant result. Okay, back on my favorite bench game. By way of a heads up, I can tell you that the school uniform stockist tell us that they've got all the items in stock that you possibly might need, and they also offer a click and collect service. So if you've got any issues with uniform, as mentioned previously in my letters and communications, do get in touch with our local stockist for a click and collect. And if you've got any other issues, contact heads of year and see if we can resolve things in advance of the school fully reopening from Monday onwards. Okay, so it's the WOW Awards again, and yet again the heads of year have been busy coming up with a creative way to present those WOW Awards, and it includes shaming me yet again. So over to the WOW Awards.
And the sailor song.
Thank you for joining in with that little song. And now it's story time. So gather yourselves close to the screen, get your cushions, and now it's time for story time. Today, we've got Wilson with us. Say hello to Wilson. Hello, Wilson. Hello. Wilson's going to be listening to our story today. Are we ready? Then we'll begin. Once upon a time, in a land not so far away, there were five heads of year and a sixth form manager who decided to reward students for their outstanding commitment to home learning. They rewarded those students who, each week, had been nominated by teachers within a certain faculty. But they wanted to reward them one last time before the home learning ceased. But this time, they wanted an outstanding worker for the whole of lockdown period. Is this a really great story so far? Their reward videos had made them YouTube sensations and the talk of the community, from superheroes to newsreaders. But what would this final video have in store? Let's find out in our story, Once Upon a Home Learning Reward.
Oh, hello there. I'm glad you found me. Here is where our story begins. The Year 7s had experienced an unusual start to secondary school life, with their Year 6 cut short, and then their virtual transition. It was the strangest beginning, but Year 7 were amazing and settled so quickly. Throughout the lockdown, some superb work was being produced, from video news reports to glorious artwork and so much more. But there had to be one overall winner for the Home Learning Reward, and that, for Year 7, was Liam Tipping. For he had been dedicated to his work, producing every task to a high standard and following all instructions exactly. Well done and congratulations, Liam.
Now we move on to Year 8's chapter. It wasn't quite the way they had planned to return to secondary school. Following the signs which guided them to the Orange Zone, it quickly became their sanctuary, strolling between F12 and F08, and not allowed to pass between the purple, blue, yellow, green and red zone. On January the 4th, it was announced that we were placed into another lockdown. Year 8 pulled up their socks and faced home learning head on, and it had to be said the quality of work they had been producing had been out of this world. But there had to be one overall winner for the Home Learning Reward, and that, for Year 8, was Ruth Baker, who was given 110% with every single task, showed tenacity, and her presentation was always exceptional. Well done, Ruth.
Well, Year 9s believe they had the worst deal of all. Starting at 8:25 and not finishing until 3 p.m. To them, the staggered starts and finishes just didn't seem fair. But they soldiered on, showed resilience, and had smiles on their faces. Well, most of them. When lockdown came, they turned to their devices for live lessons, pre-recorded lessons, and independent tasks. They then requested their WeDoc logins again. They all worked so hard, but there had to be one overall winner for the Home Learning Reward, and that, for Year 9, was Matthew Bourne. For him putting an incredible amount of effort into his work, applied his subject skills, and consistently handed his work in on time. Well done, Matthew.
Year 10 worked hard for the autumn term at school, studying, preparing for their GCSEs ahead. The change at school they all took in their stride, but some students wore their masks more like a chin warmer and needed constant reminding. When lockdown came, they got into a routine of chapter time and lessons, engaging brilliantly with their tasks. But there had to be one overall winner for the Home Learning Reward, and that For Year 10 was Jack Bentley, for his consistent approach to home learning, outstanding pieces of work, and high level of focus in tasks. Well done, Jack.
Year 11 had returned in September under an uncertain cloud, with the last lockdown leaving them with little time left in school to finish all they needed for their exams. But they came in and they focused and worked as hard as they could, whilst regularly hand washing and sanitising all the day through. The lockdown came and they continued their work to ensure their grade would reflect what they truly deserved. But there had been one overall winner for the home learning reward, and that for year 11 was Lewis Pickering. And he had completed his tasks to a good standard, clearly working hard and meeting his success criteria. Well done, Lewis.
And now our final chapter. The year 12 and 13 students, where the whole sixth form years have been thrown into confusion and the unknown. The uncertainty around whether exams would take place, with control assessments suspended and coursework delayed. But the sixth form has battled on, getting university applications submitted and continued to work with such dedication and resilience. But there had to be one overall winner for each year group. For home learning, the award in year 12 goes to Lily Hough for excellent work and high standard of engagement. And for year 13, Michelle Charles for brilliant engagement and consistently responding to feedback.
So I'm guessing you're really pleased this story has come to an end this week. Wilson definitely is, but let's find out how it ends. Now here ends this part of our story, with all lockdown home learning winners announced, and a huge congratulations to them all. But the time has almost come to see you all soon. But I'll leave you with our heads of year and sixth form manager in their final countdown. Students who were the winners of a WOW award, as always, really well deserved. If you think I should be nominated for the X Factor, then just send in your likes, because that singing I put on there was absolutely superb, my best ever. Anyway, it's the usual, it's the final thing, but it is the best thing, the gallery. Yet again, this week we've had fabulous contributions to the gallery. So it's there, it's on the website. So the last thing you do before you go to bed, please take a moment to have a look at the outstanding work that our pupils have produced over the last week. In the meantime, take care and I will speak to you again.